Hi and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I hope that you will like, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications if you're returning. Thank you, I appreciate it. And this video is not meant to be a bash or a cancel or any of those items. This is to be a constructive criticism that Boxy is not meeting our expectations, my expectations. I can't speak for anybody else. They are doing things that make me not want to subscribe. So Boxy has always had, in my opinion, most of the exciting products in boxes. Like, they tend to have the most exciting products. They tend to be a leader in new products and things that other boxes aren't offering or are, quite honestly, just being blunt, new on the market, or brands that are very high end and we get in the box that we pay $25 for, much like the Hourglass stick I talked about in my criticism in my BoxyCharm unboxing. So the Fenty box is a great example of this. That was hyped so much and it lived up to every expectation in my opinion. There was a couple items I thought they could have made better choices for, like the blotting papers, but it didn't reduce the value or my like of that box. So it's really easy for you to increase your beauty collection or your product base without spending a ton of money. So that has always been the positives of BoxyCharm. When I found it, I remember being so excited because I couldn't believe some of the stuff that they put in that box. So again, this is one of my favorite boxes I've ever subscribed to, and I'm pretty much positive I will subscribe again once the kinks are worked out, okay? Let's get started. So first of all, COVID-19 did make all the supply lines break. So we see food shortages, we see, I mean, meat at my place, the prices are going sky high, and it's honestly hard to get at this point. We're seeing shortages, Sephora closed, Ulta closed, like this affected everyone, and we know from their emails it did affect BoxyCharm. For the sheer fact that they had to have less staff, they had to space them out, all the work from home and all of those things. So the one thing I will say and I want to mention is Macy's Beauty Box did something that I think no one else did. So at the same time, I think it was in early April, Sephora announced they were ending their bag. They closed it down. They're going to do, you can just buy bags now. You have to have a subscription. And then the same week, Macy's announced they were closing down until COVID-19 got better. They didn't want to put their staff at risk. They didn't see any need to risk mailing things to people. Like, they just shut it down. And I honestly respect that better than sending subpar boxes. I would much rather wait. And then also, a lot of people are saving their money during this time period. Subscriptions are probably down. So that's just kind of where, if we have a starting place of what the situation was. So Boxy did not express any concern that I saw that they were having problems with their supply line, that they had problems really. In fact, quite the contrary, I kept seeing posts of boxes are going to ship as normal. The first month, I think it was April, shipped on time from my understanding. May, they did say it would be a little bit later. Like, it just seemed like they were kind of fluffing over any struggles that I perceive could have been happening. Again, I don't know anyone that works there. This is just my opinion, the outside looking in. So let's talk about some issues first. The first one is probably the easiest. I just want to kind of cover, and I'm not going to stay on too long, is the cards. So they had announced a while back that they're going to eventually stop sending cards and that they would send us digital copies. They wanted to be better for the environment. And I honestly can't critique that. As much as I love having my card, if that's the move they're going to, I support it. It saves them money, you know, on cardstock, printing, all of that. But it also saves, again, with our environment. So a lot of the glossy type postcards cannot be recycled, at least in my area. So I thought it was a good move. Even if I didn't love the idea, I can respect it. So intermittently, I would say probably at least in 2020, we've not received cards in boxes. So it started off that you'd get one in premium and not one in base, or vice versa. Like, it kind of went back and forth. Well, a lot of us that YouTube or that talk on chat rooms, things like that, Instagram, Messenger, you know, we discuss the variation we got. We discuss the way, like, we help others kind of identify their box as a little sneak peek before they get it. Without those cards, we don't actually know what variation it is. And then on top of that, what I started noticing initially, the boxes were great. Like, January and February, I didn't have a lot of complaint about my boxes. But as the year has gone on, they've got worse and worse, and no card to explain prices, anything. If you go on BoxyCharm, I mean, it just, to me, it seemed like it was a way for them not to have to commit to what was in the boxes. So if they didn't do a card, they could throw in whatever they wanted because they don't have to match the card. And then also, like, 1 month my base box, I received an email that said, you're not going to get a card. Here's your digital card. And of course, I have no patience, so I looked at it. And then I received my box and it had a card in it. So I'm like, you're doing double work at that point if that's, it's not happening. So that's the first thing I just kind of want to touch on. My theory is that they are using back stock and old stock. Therefore, they kind of are throwing whatever they can in the box. They don't want to have to match a card. So the next thing I want to talk about is their customer service. So BoxyCharm has never been known as having top-notch customer service. When you finally get a hold of them, they typically do take care of things. Previously, anyways. Recently, I didn't care for their response, but they typically did try eventually. So I did touch on this in my BoxyCharm video, but BoxyCharm reaches out to people on social media. You see it on Instagram, you see it on Twitter. Hey, you know, email us here. Hey, DM us. Give us the information. We're happy to help. It happened to me personally. They posted and replied to my Twitter complaining about a broken item and duplicates. And they said, DM us the details, give us your email, we'll look it up. I did that. Waited almost 16 days and never got a response. I sent an email. I got an email back that says, if you are still having a problem after you review all these help, then reply. A lot of people, I think, wouldn't reply to that. That's like a way to get rid of half of their contacts, in my opinion. I know someone who owns a web-based company, and people ask a lot of stupid questions on his company, so he typically does this because it weeds out the people that aren't serious. If you're serious, you're going to read the whole email, and you're going to reply. So when I received that email, I did reply. I think it took 4 or 5 business days before I got a response, and then it was like a, hey, you know what, that sucks. Sorry your box didn't work out for you, but hey, go buy some from BoxyCharm pop-up or add-ons. Like, to advertise to spend more money with them. If I'm an unhappy customer, I'm not going to look more investment into that company. So it just was one of those frustrating things. So I received, this is the replacement pack they sent me, and I'm going to show you that too. This is what it looks like. It literally is broken. And I emailed, they waited over 16 days to reply between Twitter and emails and everything else, and then said, oh, well, send us a picture of the brush and a picture of your box and we'll replace it. There is no one I know keeping boxes for any reason during COVID. I mean, we know it lives on hard surfaces. So I'm not keeping any of that. So I kind of had to be very direct and explain all that and say, hey, it took you guys 16 days to get back to me. If you had replied when I first sent it, I would have had my box. This month, I didn't take a picture of my box so that I could, if I had a problem. And this month, I didn't. I didn't have a problem. I didn't like my box. I didn't think my box was great, but I didn't have a problem. So I am deleting those pictures. But this is what came in, okay? So they sent me a replacement pack. And I'm just going to pull up that one. Look. Same thing. It's a design flaw. It is not a, I got a bad apple. It's a design flaw. So that is the biggest issue that I had a problem with. So if you do subscribe, keep your box until you know you're keeping everything, because if you get rid of your box, you have no way to return or exchange anything else. So the next thing I kind of want to talk about is their quizzes and reviews. So the owner came out and said, and I always mess up his name, I think it's Martin. He came out and said, hey, if you have your quizzes answered, and there's two, there's one for products and there's one for complexion. He said, if you have your quizzes answered and you're reviewing your products, you should be getting things that are to your taste and preference. Now, he did not specify as like starting this month that was going to go forward, or if it's always supposed to have been that way. I do my reviews every single month, both of my complexion and my quiz is answered. An example of that is I say no mascara on mine. This is from 2 different months. This is a mascara primer, which, by the way, I don't like. It sucks. And this is, I'm wearing it today, and it, like, did nothing. And then this is a mascara. I have none. I don't want, I think it says, it doesn't say none. It says very few. I get something every single month. So, the other side of that coin that, again, is part of those quizzes is the complexion. They have a very specific complexion quiz. It asks you your undertones, asks you your skin tone, asks you if you're oily, if you're dry, all these things, right? So I received the Iconic Illuminator in a shade that I can't use. I mean, like, literally, I am going to try to, darken one of my two light foundations and see if I can put it into it and use it that way, but if you had my complexion quiz, why was I sent something that I can't use? That, again, reduces the value of the box. Another great example of that is everybody received the Porefessional primer. They either receive this or the Hydrate. I have in mind that I'm super hydrated, or super hydrated. I wish I was super hydrated. That I'm super dry, and that I also am aging. This is not working. I've tried it a million times. It doesn't work on my skin. I need another one. So that's just two really, really big examples of how we fill out. We take, as the consumer, we're paying them, first of all. Second of all, we take the time to complete these quizzes, and they're not using them. They're not reviewing them. They're not doing anything with it. Another example that I have sitting here, and I do have an email from Boxy that I will pop up on the screen here and leave as I discuss this. In fact, let me scoot over. I'm going to pop it right here so you can read it. I received the Dominique Cosmetics, and this one is in the shade Strawberry Lemonade. And they, when I emailed, they said, oh, you got it. You got it last June, 11 months ago. And it was peach tea. This is the lemonade. What is it called? I always forget it. strawberry lemonade, so they're not duplicates because they're different shades. No, to me, that is absolutely a duplicate. First of all, let's talk about the age of the product. This is not being manufactured anymore. This was a short-term product. Sephora doesn't have it on clearance, but they only have a few left, says it right on their site. Dominique Cosmetics, it doesn't go in and out of stock. It's one of those things that they did it on purpose to get rid of old stock, but if this is 11 months old, do I really want to use it on my lips? Like, no, I don't. But also, the point of BoxyCharm is to learn about new products. The point of BoxyCharm is to get products you haven't got before. A different shade to me does not count as a different product. That's where their system is flawed. So that's, I realize it's kind of a rant, but I don't like that. I think that if you've already had this, what if I hated it? I don't. I like Dominique Cosmetics. This is not a bash on them. What if I hated this? What if it was the worst? I'd have two lip glosses I don't like. Like, it's just, it's really stupid. So let me move back into the center of the screen now that I've taken that down. My suggestion for BoxyCharm would be to stop recycling any product that has been received by a current subscriber. So like the lip gloss, I shouldn't have received that because it's just because it's a different shade, that shouldn't count. Their system is flawed there. Another old product that I received was the Juice Beauty lip gloss. Liquid lip. I thought it was lip gloss because it went on so slippery and slimy. I was like, oh, another lip gloss. Cool. And then I didn't even connect it until I was watching someone else's video. And they're like, that's weird. This is supposed to be a liquid lip gloss or liquid lip. And then I went and tested mine again. And it is. It's separated. It's old. It's not good. I mean, it was ridiculous. Never even got a reply in my email. They never even replied. So that's one of the items that it's just these old and repeats and palettes and items from prior months. Like, it just, they need to stop that. If they want to do it for brand new subscribers, cool. Give it to them. Not the old stuff. Don't give anybody the old stuff. I'm talking about the from old boxes, reusing items as for this. Like, the last 2 months has been all old items pretty much. I mean, it's crazy. This month for June looks ridiculous. The next thing I want to talk about is, I already talked about duplicates and things like that, but also the palettes and other items. So I think it was March, we could have got 3 palettes or a mask. And from what I saw, vast majority of people got the mask. There were definitely people that got the palettes, but I don't know many people that would want a mask instead of an eyeshadow palette. And for me, it was a real big one because I have marked on there little masks, more palette, like a lot of palettes and a very few masks. So again, my preferences were not being honored. So one of the things I've noticed too is that we're not getting items that have accurate values. Like, we're told it's valued at one thing, but it's actually something else, or it's just flat out a low value product. So like one example I have is this Beauty Creations Kelly Chic. This is a $15 palette. This was in my base box. If it had been in my premium, I would have lost it. But not that we're not getting crappy products on that one too, but this one is a $15 product. For me, if you have Smashbox 1 month, $45, $50 palette, and the next month you send a $15 palette, like, it makes no sense. And here's the thing, is if you take out the items that they're doing that with, the ones that they, the prices are exaggerated, it reduces the value box. My premium was not valued correctly in the month of May. So again, putting cheaper products in. So a great example of the price, like, fudging is what I'm gonna call it. It is obviously valued one thing, however, they're listing it for another. So the first item I'm going to show that has the inflated pricing, and I'm not going to talk long on this product because I really believe it's kind of been beat to death. This is the 24K Gold Foil Moisturizer. I actually didn't realize I still had this. I thought I had given it away, and then I was cleaning out my closet. I used to have like a beauty shelf in there, and it must have fell behind because I found it back there. So this retailed, I believe, $100, if I'm not mistaken, is what they said it retailed for. Very quickly, people found it on Alibaba for like $1.90. So this has a value of $1.90 now. That box that I got it in loses all that $100 down to $2. Like, that's not value. And to me, I feel like you're cheating your customer when you pass along a cheap product. And actually, honestly, I'm gonna give credit on one thing that I criticized. So this one, everybody knows the price. It's $15. If it's valued at $15, you could buy it today for $15. This one I can go buy for $1.90. It's not valued at $100. So while I didn't like this on my box, I respect this more than this because this has the air, like the aroma of deceit. So that is a great example. Another example, quite honestly, is the brush, Baddington brush and lash situation and opulent brushes. These are the opulent. These retail for $40. You do get 3. I did receive one extra in my box for some reason, but these are like literally like cheapy Chinese. They're not like this one is not a good brush. Like, it's already shedding everywhere. Like, they're just not good brushes. I would not pay $40 for 3 of these. I would probably pay less than $5 per brush for these. That'd be $15. So no, it's not worth $40. A great example is these Baddington lashes. These retail for $26 on Baddington's website. This is the Harlow 3D Silk Lashes. They do look like this. They are ridiculous. They pop off your eye. They do. I mean, you can search on YouTube. There's tons of videos about how horrible these are. But also, they're not like super thick luxe. They don't look to be made well. And so to charge $26, there is no way I would do this. And the last one I'm going to mention, and I want to make a point after I mention this, because there's something connecting all of these products that I just think is something interesting and goes to the notion that they created them to fill the boxes. So this is the Baddington brushes, and I'm keeping them in the box because I'm not keeping them. I actually are giving them to a friend, but they do look like this. These I actually think are very pretty. I think they're decent brushes, but they're not $90 brushes. They are $40 for both or $30 for both. I personally think $30 for both, and I think that's stretching it. I think that's me giving a little bit. So one of the things that I have noticed about these is that a lot of these products, this one in particular, but this is not the only one that I have found, because I believe it was the Opulent Beauty was the same thing. They have no presence. They're not known in the beauty industry. And it's not about being an unknown company. It's about being a brand new company. When we received this, they had literally just created their Instagram page. So on one hand, if it wasn't found in Alibaba, I probably would have been like, oh, they're giving a brand new brand. A just beginning company, a head start, they're helping out, blah, 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 blah. But then it came out too that this one, this fascia, is owned by another company, Steve Laurent. So it's just one of those things that, no, they're just throwing things out there and making a ton of money off of it, because they're giving us a value that they're telling us is $125 or above, but really it's probably running around $50 or $70, which, again, I know the naysayers will go, we only paid $25 for the box. It doesn't matter. The point is if you guarantee there's a value, and honestly, that just dawned on me a great example. Last summer, Colored Rain did mystery boxes. They screwed up. The first set of boxes they sent out did not have the value they promised. They rectified it. They were not rude. They were polite. But people went back shit crazy over the fact that the values didn't add up. But this is happening every month with BoxyCharm. And you get these people that are just like, I don't care. I'm getting my value. No, you're not. If you're not getting $125 or $175 for premium. My premium wasn't $175 this month, mainly due to these. But the point is that this is something BoxyCharm needs to fix. If they want to have value in that product and they want to have consistency in ordering, they want to maintain their customer base and have happy customers, they need to truly bring the value. That is the essential point of BoxyCharm. So I answered this question in my other video, but I'm going to say it again. Will I never subscribe? No, honestly, I love BoxyCharm. I honestly think it's a very inventive and awesome system. I love having a choice. I think they should be more consistent on telling us when the choices are going to be, although that has improved recently. It hasn't got a lot better. But I think that they are a really good, what's that I'm trying to say? They're a great enterprise. What they're doing is amazing, but there are some quirks and some things that need to be fixed. So that is enough ranting about BoxyCharm. If you like this video, I hope that you will like it. I hope that you will subscribe, ring the bell for notifications. And I will be posting Saturday, just a heads up. I will be posting my Huda Beauty mystery bags. And I am going to have a contest in that. So I'm going to be giving away at least one item, I think. I've had to film it 3 times now. So I think I know which item I'm going to give away. But it's valued at just over $25. So it's not a huge thing, but it is a free item for you if you watch, like, and subscribe. Have a great day, guys.